This is No One from Nowhere, and you are, and I am, a Spirit of God. Today I want to talk to you about a very, very important, imperative question a viewer, subscriber, not sure, asked me. And it has to do with the Anunnaki, Christianity, and Jesus Christ. Can you be a Christian and worship the Anunnaki, hence Jesus Christ? Here's this question. So who is Jesus? Please, I want to know after finding out the truth about the Anunnaki. I am not able to pray right, and is Enki our father? Also, who is to pray right after finding out this truth? Please help me. My mind is so stuck right now, I can't even think right. All right, well, thank you so much. And first off, we're all going to die, and the sky is falling, and the ship's sinking. I'm just joking. No, but this is a very, very important question, because at one point in my life, this was a very big thing for me, and it really broke my heart. And I couldn't believe, like, my mind was blown, and I couldn't believe it, but therefore I had to do what I do right now. And anyways, you know, my dad is a poker player. I've said this in other videos, and, you know, he tells me about tells. And to be honest with you, nonverbal communication is 50% of all communication, at least. And I actually went to school, one of my bachelor's is in nonverbal communication. And yes, the middle finger is definitely nonverbal communication. So please, I can't see you, so it's all good. But I'm just going to tell you, a tell is on the Pope's hat. If you look at the Pope's hat, and you look at the bottom picture, this is either Dagon or Enki, the fish god. Enki is the god of water, and the Oannesses helped Dagon, i.e. Enki, and in my opinion, the Pope is an Oannes of a pagan belief of Enki, hence i.e. the Anunnaki. So they wear a fish mitre. So the Catholic Church, hence Constantine, started the Christian faith, i.e. Jesus Christ, hence Christianity. So this is a big tell that yes, the Christian doctrine was started by someone that believed in, you know, parentheses, pagan beliefs, but they are the Anunnaki. Next, I'm going to talk to you about the Elohim to Abraham. And remember, Abraham was from Ur, and this is in Mesopotamia. And they worship the Anunnaki in Mesopotamia. And if you are a Christian, Jew, or are Islamic, you believe in Abraham because he is the father of these three religions. And I also will be rehashing, in some senses, another video. Genesis 1:26. Then God said, "Let us make human beings in our image to be like us." Genesis 3:22. Then the Lord God said, "Look, the human beings have become like us, knowing both good and evil." Do you ever wonder who God is? Do you ever wonder who the us in the gods are? And how does Jesus Christ tie into all this? I take you to Mark 15:34. The death of Jesus Christ. Then at 3 o'clock, Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Elo, Elo, lema sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you abandoned me?" You'll also find the same but different spelling in Matthew 27:46. Jesus Christ was talking in Aramaic Targum instead of Hebrew. And this does tie back to Genesis 1:26. El, Elo, Eli, equates to Elohim. You see, El is the meaning for many deities stemming from ancient Mesopotamia. El is equated to Anu, and he is, or King Anu, and he is the father god of the 70 Elohim gods. The father god, or El, is King An, or Anu, from Nibiru. His pantheon is 70 other gods. And the highest triad, or three, is King Anu, Lord Enlil, and Lord Enki. There are 7 main gods, and also another 5. But this is where the Anunnaki come from. King Anu equals Anunnaki. El appears in Genesis 217 times, Psalms 73 times, and 75 times in Job. Now I'm going to skip down to Psalm 97:9. For you, Lord Enlil, or Yahweh, Lord Enlil or Yahweh, are most high, El, or King Anu, over all the earth. You are raised high over all the gods. Abraham was from Ur, which I mentioned, and is in Mesopotamia. They worshipped many deities of El and the Anunnaki pantheon. If you believe in Christianity, Islamic, or Judaism, then you are under an Abrahamic religion. Yahweh or Enlil was not revealed yet. Abram, A-B-R-A-M, was blessed by El or King Anu. Genesis 15:19-20. Melchizedek blessed Abram with this blessing. Bless be Abraham by God, Most High, King Anu, creator of heaven and earth. And blessed be God, Most High, El, or King Anu, who has defeated your enemies for you. And this is probably the most important verse that is a pivotal point for Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Genesis 17:1. Speaking to Abram, when Abram was 99 years old, the Lord God appeared to him and said, I am El Shaddai, God Almighty. This is King Anu, and hence Lord Enlil. Serve me faithfully and live a blameless life. This verse is absolutely Lord Enlil through King Anu. They are one and the same, and their motives on earth from Nibiru are one and the same. I hope this helps you out, because I want you to feel like you can have your own faith and it's okay to believe in the Anunnaki pantheon. Because I want to remind you that all roads and all things in this world are 7 continents. We are the 7th planet from Nibiru. The number 7 and 9 are huge. And all divisions and there and so on of 9, 7, and 12 are very important numerologies. But I want you to know it's okay, because Jesus Christ is a part of the Anunnaki, and the Pope who worships, you know, Jesus Christ as well as the Anunnaki is pictured right here. But anyways, I leave you with a joke about faith. There really isn't one, because faith is serious. And no matter what I say, it's all owned by you. Because at the end of the day, you are your own beliefs. It's up to you. But I'm going to leave you with a few jokes anyways. Atheism is a non-proof profit organization. When you get at your wit's end, you'll find God lives there. And lastly, don't let your worries get the best of you. Remember, Moses started out as a basket case. I love you so much, and so does God. And always remember that you are, and I am, a spirit of God. In Jesus' name, amen.